little has changed with the Subaru WRX in the last 3 years except the numbers it produces. In our test, a 2017 model outran the original 2015 edition by an impressive 4.0 seconds at our Lightning Lap event on Virginia International Raceway's Grand West course. But the 2018 example we drove for this report lagged behind earlier WRXs we tested. The elephant in the room is its 5.5 second 0-60 mph time, 0.5 seconds slower than our long-term 2015 WRX. A closer look at the data is needed. Our first test of the brand new 2015 WRX produced a 6.3 second 5-60 mph rounding start time. Fast forward to today, and the time has ballooned to 7.1 seconds. That rolling start and our 30-50 mph and 50-70 mph top gear acceleration tests all removed the highly variable launch from the results, and the 18 WRX was slower in all three measures. Clearly this WRX, like any aging quarterback whose name doesn't rhyme with mum lady, has lost a step with age. So the question becomes this: is a less quick WRX a less good one? The answer is not really, although time, as ever, exacts a toll. Some things change, some things stay the same. The WRX still comes standard with a 6-speed manual transmission, but a continuously variable automatic remains optional under the hood. The numbers haven't changed. The turbocharged 2.0-liter flat four zings out 268 horsepower and 258 pounds-ft of torque. Subaru's FA20 engine is a relatively unassuming way to make that much snort, relying on a twin-scroll turbo to deliver both the down-low yank and 15.9 pounds of maximum boost, but it's not without burden. Wide throttle openings at low RPM yield a lumpy, uneven power delivery as the engine struggles to make big torque against the nut threshold, with its responses being consistently behind our right foot's requests and it hanging onto rails between gears. The FA20's drivability leaves us wishing for the crisper snap of aftermarket tuned versions we've driven.